7:50 on your Sunday morning. It's Queen of Free time. Last week, Cherie Lowe talked about what to cut. This week, she's talking about habits to add into your life to improve your finances. So, Cherie, how does transferring money out of your checking benefit you?
So there is this theory called the partitioning effect. And the idea is that if we get a big bag of chips, we're more likely to eat the whole thing. But if we separate it out into smaller parts, we're less likely to do the very same thing. And that works with your money as well. So if we can get that money out of our checking account, pass it through, obviously, to bills and needs first, but then into savings accounts. I think we have about 9 savings accounts linked to our personal checking account. Move it. If you really need it, you can always put it back into the checking account, obviously. But once you move it out, I promise you, you are less likely to touch it. Super simple step that doesn't cost you anything.
Great habit to start that one. So also, why do you suggest keeping a to-buy list?
So we can't always go out and get the things that maybe we even need immediately if we don't have the cash to support it. Mm-hmm. And so rather than, you know, bemoaning ourselves or overextending ourselves, keep a running list of things you need. For right now, our family needs some new towels. They're looking pretty sad. So that's on my to-buy list. Once we have extra funds come in, we can get by on what we have for a season, but at least we know that hit list. We're ready to take it on as soon as we have
when
the extra
have the money. Too. How can you train yourself to consistently look for coupons to use?
Coupons are everywhere, and they've never been easier to use with digital and app options. And so there's no reason why you shouldn't take a few minutes before you go to the grocery store to look on the grocery store's app. If you're shopping in the mall, Google search before you walk in the store. It's free money. We need to consistently make that tiny effort to save a few dollars.
All right, this is one that I definitely struggle with. How does going to bed on time help you save money?
This is a professional hazard for you.
Yes,
obviously,
it is.
You have to be here very early during the day, but our sleep affects everything. And so if our mood is off, we're more likely to make impulse purchases or emotional decisions with our money. Power down your devices at least an hour before bedtime, mm-hmm. and hit the hay on time consistently. We actually have friends that occasionally will text us and say, you need to go to bed right now, because it's a struggle for all of us sometimes.
Yes. So. And also can help with your weight gain, too,
yes.
and weight loss program, too. So mm-hmm. multiple benefits
it
there.
Does.
This other one, how powerful is that shopping list? I know you talk about it all the time, talking about shopping the perimeter as well, but that shopping list
the
in
grocery
particular.
List. So there is another theory called choice distraction. And the idea is that anytime we step into the mall, the grocery store, a big box retailer, we have to constantly say no to ourselves. And there are thousands upon 10,000s of products that encounter us as we go through the store, and we keep saying no, no, no. Mm-hmm. If we have a list in advance, we're automatically kind of X-ing out all of those things that we would say no to. Mm-hmm. The more we have to say no, the tireder we get, the more impulse buys we make, which is why there's all that candy in the aisle as we check out and we're tempted to pick it up. So make that grocery list, even if you're in your car, before you go into the store, mm-hmm. and it will help. Put it on your phone, scratch paper, whatever it takes.
Grab your blinders too, right?
Exactly. Only focus on that list.
Focus.
Don't get the other things.
Cherie, thank you so much. And if you need a refresher of all of these things that Cherie just talked about, we have a link on WTHR.com with all of those recommendations there and more.